Please be seated. Kia ora tātou, tālo whalawa, kia ora nā tātou kātou toa, mā loelelei. Whakalofalahi atu, kia mto luosi, whakatālo whātu, nisam blovinaka nā turanga ke nā marama. Mālo ni, warm Pacific greetings, or as we say in Otahuhu, what's up young homies? It's so delightful to see you all here this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, it's wonderful to see you all. My name is John Pulu. Please stop referring to me as Dwayne The Rock Johnson. It's really disturbing. Welcome. A warm welcome to the Prime Minister of New Zealand, Jacinda Ardern, Minister Aupito Su'a William-Seal, our church leaders, community leaders, traditional leaders, and anyone who wants to be a leader. Warm welcome to you all. Welcome to the Prime Minister's Pacific Youth Awards. I'm delighted to MC it for the second time. This is the only time my mother allows me to leave the house. Now, if you didn't know, the Prime Minister's Pacific Youth Awards is a Ministry for Pacific Peoples initiative, which recognises excellence and outstanding achievement by Pacific youth aged 17 to 24 in New Zealand. So that excludes me, because I'm only 16 years old. There are 8 categories and 11 awards which will be awarded for the achievement in areas such as leadership, business, arts, creativity, science, and within the community. Can I firstly acknowledge, as you walked in earlier, you may have heard the wonderful, exquisite sound of the string or orchestra. They're known as the Virtuoso Strings Orchestra from Porirua. A round of applause. They are so good, I've invited them to my wedding, my funeral, and my birthday. I'd also like to acknowledge the Te Tau Dance Group. A big, beautiful welcome. A round of applause for them. I invited them later on to my hotel room. No one's laughing. Now, I'm going to quickly go through the house rules. Now, welcome once again to the banquet hall. In case of a fire, because the only thing that's lit right now is your beautiful smiles. Should there be a fire alarm sound, please evacuate the venue via the same route you entered or via the nearest safe exit. Please follow the directions of security staff and fire wardens. The assemble point is outside at the sit-in status, statue, out at the front lawn, or otherwise just run quickly as you can, please. And if you're Tongan, help take all the mats, please. I need it for my wedding. In case of a medical emergency, in the event of a medical emergency, please refrain from texting 111. Inform security or venue staff immediately. Security will manage any medical emergency within the parliamentary complex. In case of an earthquake, in the event of an earthquake, drop, cover, and hold until it stops. I know it's a bit like a dance move. Please keep away from the windows and other obvious hazards in the venue. Please remain inside the venue and await instructions from the security staff. Visitor stickers. On arrival, you were issued with visitor stickers. That's a little freebie you can take home to your families. That you can keep that one. Please ensure it's clearly visible. Don't wear it on your forehead. Your visitor stickers is required until you exit the premises. The bathrooms, the whaliwila, hufanga whakatapu. The toilet facilities for the banquet hall are located in the far corner of the hall near the main entrance. Smoking, just don't smoke, that's not cool. Telephones, telefoni or telefoni. Please switch your mobile phones to silent for the duration of the event. Photos are permitted within the venue space booked. Please do not take photos anywhere outside of this room. Only selfies are allowed. Division bells. Now, every Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday during sitting weeks, the division bells will sound for the member in the debating chamber at 1:50 p.m. Past that already. And 6 p.m., I think. Yep, now we're past that. And again at 7:20 p.m. and at 10 p.m., my bedtime, on Tuesday and Wednesday. The division bells may on occasion ring outside of these times due to the voting in the debating chamber. Now, that's a fun little fact there for you to tell your family when you go home. Also, a warm Pacific greetings to everyone that's viewing tonight's award ceremony via the Ministry for Pacific Peoples Facebook page. A warm welcome to my family in Tonga, because Facebook is still available. Mālo aupito, sai ki tau ilo. Now, in our Pacific tradition, I'd now like to invite to come forward Reverend Perema Leasi Kiwesem to open up our evening with a prayer. Malo Ampito.
Let us come before God in prayer. Let us pray. Lord God, our Creator, you are the giver of all we possess, the source of all our blessings. Tonight we are gathered here to celebrate the recipients of the Prime Minister, the Right Honourable Jacinda Ardern's Youth Award, which recognises academic excellence and outstanding achievement by Pacific youth in Aotearoa, New Zealand. Loving God, we thank you for the love of your servant, Jacinda Ardern. We pray for your blessings upon her, her dear family, and particularly in her role as the Prime Minister of Aotearoa, New Zealand. We pray now for each recipient tonight. We thank you for their determination, hard work, and service to their communities in achieving these awards. Lord of the future, may all the recipients remember that this award aims to recognize not just those who do well academically, but also our Pacific youth who give selflessly to their communities. It aims to pursue knowledge, knowledge that will enable them to embrace opportunities and take on challenges with clear vision and purpose. Gracious God, we thank you for the recipients, parents, and families, for their love, support, prayers, and encouragement. May your blessings be upon them. We thank you for the teachers, tutors, and educational institutions. May you bless them for their ongoing guidance and mentoring. We pray for all the sponsors of this award. Father, bless them. We thank you for the Ministry of Pacific Peoples, the Minister, Honourable Aupito Tofae Su'a William Seal, Chief Executive La'ulu Mac Leawanai, and all staff members for organizing this event. May you bless them for their contribution to the growth of our Pacific youth in helping them to fulfill their dreams for the future. Our loving God, may your blessings be upon us all distinguished guests, families and friends who are gathered here tonight. We pray now for the presence of your Holy Spirit in this special occasion tonight. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Thank you very much, Reverend Perema Leasi Kiwesem. Thank you very much. It's very exciting to be here amongst our recipients tonight and here to have our leader of the country acknowledging the leaders of tomorrow. Did you like that? Thank you. I've been rehearsing that all night. Thank you. Stand by, epic music. Now, I'm going to invite now Minister Aupito Su'a William Seal. He's the young prince of Mangere, to come forward and address you all. So please, make him feel welcome.
O upui malayo vavau ma malai tele, ua paia le sami malau ilele, ua paia foi fale, paia fafo, paia lunga, ua paia lalo, ua paia vasa I vasa, awa ua paia foi tamal langi, ua paia tamal malo, ua paia foi tamal lau ilele, faftai lau sungal fafengainga, moltato tal sangamu moli, o te talitonu lava, wa mu matalia le tātou taulanga osi. Ai tau ia ina ia maua ni anganga a wale atua malona finangalo e tusa matapua inga ile nei tai au liunga lua. Talo falava malo lelei ki rana tato katoa toa, talo hani, whakalofalaiatu, nisa bula binaka, ngā mihi nui o koutou katoa, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. I do want to acknowledge the presence of the Right Honourable Prime Minister of New Zealand, my parliamentary colleagues, Chris Farfoy, Poto Williams, Anahila Kanogataa Sui Sui Ki, Agnes Loheni. I acknowledge also the presence of the members of the diplomatic corps. I acknowledge our church leaders, our traditional leaders, our chiefs and orators, our business leaders, our community leaders. I acknowledge also the presence of Izzy Ford, the Deputy Mayor of Porirua, who is with us. But I particularly want to acknowledge our young awardees and their families. Warm Pacific greetings to you and each of you tonight. Welcome to Parliament. Welcome to the Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern's Pacific Youth Awards celebration. In accordance with protocol, can I now also take the liberty on your behalf and welcome tonight the presence of our Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern. Prime Minister, your presence tonight adds dignity and mana to this event. We appreciate all you do for this beautiful country of ours. We acknowledge how hard a task you have of carrying on your shoulders the weight of responsibility for our entire nation. I'm proud to be a member of your government and to support your wonderful leadership. Our communities appreciate your wonderful example of a new kind of political leadership, a positive and compassionate politics based on the value of aroha, alofa, a value that Pacific people strive to uphold and cherish. Tonight we've come together to honour and celebrate a few of the very best of our young people, each of whom has excelled in their area. These are members of the rising Pacifica population I often refer to as the Generation 6Bs, a generation that is brown, beautiful, brainy, bilingual, bicultural and bold. Take Sela, for example, who even before coming here tonight has been recognised as a top academic achiever, helping lay the foundation for what we hope will be a successful engineering career. Or Chanel and Dei Chalei, who are doing so much to shape their communities as leaders, mentors, and entrepreneurs. I smile because I ask her how to pronounce her name. It is always uplifting in my role to meet with young people like Sela, Chanel, and Dejalay, and to hear from them directly. And those conversations so often generate new ideas. They inspire me, they help remind me of what it means to be a young Pacific Islander today, what the challenges are, what the hopes are for our communities. But more than this, whenever I sit down with young people, I come away with a sense of confidence and hope, because there is so much we are yet to accomplish, and it is this generation who will be the ones to make it happen. It's this goal of making a better future for current and future generations that compels someone like Okirana, who at just 17 years of age is helping tell the story of young people in the Pacific nations. His work is helping us understand their hopes and aspirations for the future and what we can do to fulfill them. And then there is Manuhapai, who is using art to create a space for queer identities in our Pacific culture, and Luisa, who is making sure our Pacific culture shaped our response to challenges like climate change. Prime Minister, I met Luisa in Tuvalu, and she's still there. So her parents are here tonight to receive her award. Every one of these young people are part of a young Pacific population that is among the fastest growing in the country. They are our future, New Zealand's Pacific future. And right now, they stand at the intersection between Pacific history, language and culture, and modern Aotearoa. From here, they bring a unique worldview to the decisions we must take as a nation, diverse ethnicities, cultures and languages that will help to shape and reshape Aotearoa New Zealand now and long into the future. Take Aotearoa, Alexia and Ioane, who are doing so much to creating stronger connections between Pacific people and opportunities in the world of science, technology, engineering and math. I see them as the modern-day navigators and explorers in the global digital economy. Thanks to this sort of work, I know that we're going to be living in a world where more and more of the innovations that shape our lives will be coming from Pacific people. And that cannot happen without people like Keith and Tupou, who understand the role of business must play in creating products and services that reflect who we are. One thing I love more than anything else about these awards is that they give us the chance to recognize those Pacific young people who are already leading in innovation in their respective fields with confidence and resilience. They are our scientists, storytellers, visionaries, innovators, creative artists, explorers, and modern-day navigators in the blue Pacific continent and beyond. This is a big night for all of you and your families, and for all those who supported you on this journey, and those who came before and paved the way, enjoy it. Enjoy the celebrations. We are delighted to have the chance to share it with you. Finally, I'd like to thank our sponsors for their invaluable support. These events don't happen without your constant support. I also want to thank Laulu and the Ministry for Pacific Peoples team that made the event happen tonight. And of course, thank you, Prime Minister, for recognising these exceptional young people and for the shining example that you are to many of them. To all the recipients of these awards, remember who you are. Remember your roots and your heritage. Remember your parents, your families, your communities. Remember the values that they hold. Remember we all are connected. And remember also my definition of a young person. As long as your mum and dad are alive, you're a young person. And so with that, it is now my great pleasure to welcome our Prime Minister, the Right Honourable Jacinda Ardern, to address us.
Kia ora koutou katoa, nga mihi nui ki a koutou, kia ora ana, malola li, whakalofalahi atu, talofa lava, kia ora ana, malo ni, bulawanaka. Welcome to your place, the New Zealand Parliament. And I'll start by acknowledging my very young friend, Opuero Wimsiho, he is so young at heart. And he is the only minister that when I travel with will insist, when any young person is even vaguely near him, insist that they take a selfie of us together. Whether they want one or not, they are obliged. He does an incredible job for us, and I'm incredibly proud to work alongside him, so thank you, Opuero. I'm actually not going to traverse all of the acknowledgements that have already been made. I acknowledge you, ministers, MPs, reverends, guests. I want to start instead where the young people that we're honouring tonight would probably want me to start. And I'm imagining you'd probably want me to start with your support crew. Every time I've been in the presence of our young Pacific community, so often they are so humble that they immediately talk about the people that supported them to be where they are. And I picked that up from the last awards and the speeches that were delivered. So I just want to start with those who are family, with those who have supported the young people who are here tonight to put them in the position that they are in, to keep them fed, keep them watered, keep them loved. Thank you for the role that you've played in their lives. And now I turn to all of you. I was sitting thinking last night, what is it that I'd like to say to this extraordinary group of young people who I had the chance to go through their bios and their contribution to our country and felt so humbled reading it. And I thought, what could I possibly say to you that you wouldn't already have such a deep appreciation of? Well, I thought I'd first share that in all honesty, there are many things that I love about this job, but the thing that keeps me motivated is my contact with young people and children. Hands down, that is what keeps me going. And I wondered last night when I was thinking about what I would say today, why is it that that keeps me so motivated? And I thought in part it will be just your honesty, particularly the children that I go and have a chance to talk to. I'll give you a small example. I visited one of my local primary schools not that long ago, and on one of these screens they had, in just a humble library behind me, they had a very large photo of my head, all done up for a billboard or something like that. So, you know, my hair was just right, my face looked, you know, a bit done up. And here I was standing in real time next to this giant enlarged billboard behind me. And I opened up for questions from the children. A hand shoots up, and this young person, not a bit of irony, "Why don't you look like your picture?" I love the honesty. But I love that honesty as well, because we are in a really difficult time in our global lives. We've been challenged in ways that we haven't as a global community been challenged before, whether it's our fractured society, whether it's inequality, whether it's mental health, whether it's climate change. And young people don't shy away from that brutal reality. In fact, they keep us and hold us to account, but also seek to find their own solutions. So I love the honesty. Secondly, there is nothing harder than being a young person. There isn't. You know, I would have thought that actually, probably you'd think that this part and period in my life would be pretty tough, and I'll acknowledge the role of Prime Minister. It comes with its ups and downs, but you could not pay me to go back and be a 17-year-old again. It is hard being young. And yet, when I go out and visit those young people, the resilience that I see, in spite of how difficult it is, the ability for them to look beyond themselves and look at their community and find ways, despite whatever they're going through in their lives, to seek to support others, to find a better future for themselves, that resilience gives me great heart. And finally, my final reason why I take such heart from visiting with our rangatahi: you're our leaders of right now. You're not our leaders of tomorrow. This award isn't about tonight saying, keep going and maybe one day you can be a leader. You are leaders. And we need to get over this idea that with age comes with responsibility. You're wearing it now. And we need that now more than ever. And so that is why you keep me motivated, you keep me going, you give me hope, and you make me feel like I'm never doing this job alone. You're right there alongside everyone who is fighting to make things a bit different and a bit better for those who go before them. So, thank you. That is finally what I wanted to say. These awards are an acknowledgement of your contribution, what you're already doing, and they're our way of saying on behalf of Aotearoa, thank you. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa.
Hoi ki māma tāpule, ladies and gentlemen, we're now going to begin our award ceremony. So what's going to happen is I'm going to announce the sponsor. We have 11 recipients tonight, so the sponsor will come up, followed by the winner. They all know they're going to win tonight, so it's no big surprise to them. And then the Prime Minister, I beg your indulgence, as well as Minister Aupito will also present the award, and then the winner will come and say a speech. We're going to have Virtuoso stand by. We're going to do the cinemas. When the speech is too long, we're going to start playing a little symphony. So just to give them a cue. But that's how we're going to work out tonight. Okay, first up, the first category is Arts and Creativity Award, sponsored by Creative New Zealand and Massey University. Representing Creative New Zealand is Makerita Urale, Arts Practice Director, and the presenter from Massey, Herbert Bartley, Creative Director, Pacific Toi Rauwharangi, the College of Creative Arts. And the winner is Manu Ha'apai Vaia Tangitau. Mō paspas mai. Manu Ha'apai is 21 years old and is of Tongan descent, a valued member of the queer Moana Oceanic Arts Collective, FAFSWAG, since 2016. Alongside his peers, Manu Ha'apai continues to navigate and craft spaces that encourage the safe exploration and dissection of our shared experience. Mō paspas mai. A round of applause for Manu Ha'apai Vaia Tangitau. And he's going to update his profile photo for Facebook with that photo. So he's now going to address you all. A round of applause.
Mine's a really tragic photo I took it in the streets of South Korea, and it was really hot, and I was really bothered. I'd like to really, really thank my sisters who flew from Australia to be here with me, my grandparents and my ongo mātua, who are sitting in the crowd chilling, you know. They drove 11 hours to be here with me, and that's really, really lovely. I'd love to thank Karen and Herbie, Karina, Makareta. Y'all really holding it down. Y'all had me like questioning myself a bit in the interview room, but y'all really came through, and I really appreciate that you guys have given me the opportunity to contribute to the backbone of society, and that's what art is. I thank you deeply. I thank you all.
Maloa pito and congratulations, manuha apai. The second category is the Business and Entrepreneurship Award. The sponsor is Pacific Business Trust. May I invite Tevita Funaki, the CEO of Pacific Business Trust, to come forward. Maloa lele Tevita. How's it going? Good to see you. All right. And the winner is Keith Toma. Pats, pats, pats. Now, Keith is 21 years old and is of Niuean, Samoan, Tokelauan, Tongan, and Tuvaluan descent. Goodness me, that's the whole Pacific region. In his last years of high school, he was involved in the Young Enterprise Scheme, where he led the business group Matai Nonu and created a Pacific-inspired skincare range. Oh, can I have some of that, please? Only if it's anti-aging, of course. Now, the skincare range proved successful by being awarded with Excellence in Pacific Business by the Ministry for Pacific Peoples. A round of applause for Keith Toba.
Cool, thank you so much. Maloni, I'm Keith Toma. Thank you so much to the Prime Minister and the Minister of Pacific Peoples and our sponsor, Pacific Business Trust. I'm so humbly grateful for this award, especially in this category for business and entrepreneurship. This is a space I'm super passionate about, and I've been pursuing this for most of my life since leaving high school. And yes, I'm only 21, but sometimes I do feel like an old lady sometimes, because, you know, this journey has been so, so long. The main reason why I wanted this award is I truly want to push entrepreneurship in the Pacific space, to inspire our young Pacific entrepreneurs and educate our Pacific people that, yes, entrepreneurship is a career path, because I've seen it all in my journey, with the many failures it takes to create a successful startup, and also the hardships in the Pacific business space. This award is a great small step, and I dedicate it to my parents. What I remember is when I decided to drop out of university and kind of take entrepreneurship as my full-time job, I can remember clearly the confusion on my parents' face. But thanks to them, when they themselves were not fully supportive in the beginning, they still gave me the time and the space to cultivate this dream. Where today, they're my number one supporters and my alarm clocks when I have to go to the Otara flea markets to sell my products. So all I can say to all the inspiring, aspiring entrepreneurs is just to be resilient. It took me over 20 failed business concepts to start up my business called Banigeke. So if I had to impart to any aspiring entrepreneur, it's just to be resilient, never give up. Thank you. Whakapatailasi.
Hakaetailahi lele, thank you very much. All right, ladies and gentlemen, vuvale. The next award, still with the Business and Entrepreneurship Award, sponsored by the Pacific Business Trust. The winner is Alexia Hilbertidou. Please, make her feel welcome. Alexia is 20 years old and of Samoan and New Zealand European descent. When she was 16 years old, she was the only female in her digital technology class At 17, the only female in her advanced physics class, and now at 20, leads an organization dedicated to changing these statistics. She is the creator of Girl Boss New Zealand, a 12,500-strong community of young women passionate about male-dominated fields. Girl Boss is a social enterprise with a mission to inspire. A round of applause for Alexia Hilbertidu.
Bulavanaka, Fakalofo Atu, Kirana, Malo, Talofalava, Tina Koto Katoa, and warm Pacific greetings to you all. I have the honour and privilege to collect this award on behalf of the thousands of young women I work with at Girl Boss New Zealand. The demographic of our members are the demographic of our people. Our members who are spread across the Pacific are united by their commitment to use their God-given talents to make a positive impact on the world. Currently, only 2% of our NZX CEOs are women, and those young women are changing that. Only 8.3% of our chartered engineers are women. They're changing that too. For New Zealand to reach its full potential, both men and women must reach their full potential. My own commitment to living a life of service to the community is the result of the values instilled in me by my late Samoa Nana, who passed away 4 years ago. I know that she'll be so proud to know that I was standing here today about to embark on this journey. I'd like to thank my family who have been with me every step of the way. I commend the inspirational Pacifica youth in the room today. I'd like to thank the Ministry for Pacific Peoples, the Pacific Business Trust, the sponsors and the supporters. I believe in the unlimited possibilities for Pacifica youth to change the world through business. And in presenting me with this award, you send a message that you believe in that potential too. Whawhetai, Manue.
Thank you so much, Alexia. Ladies and gentlemen, the next category is Commercial and Corporate Award. The sponsor is Deloitte. And to present the award is Linda Mead, a partner at Deloitte. So please come forward, Linda. The winner of this award is Tupou Veiogo. A round of applause. Tupou Veiogo is 20 years old and was born and raised in Fiji. He is currently studying accounting at Massey University in Palmerston North. Tupou has achieved academic success by receiving a Certificate of Excellence in Intermediate Financial Accounting in his second year of study. He was also given the opportunity to intern with Cotton Kelly Services, an audit firm in Palmerston North. He has been involved in supporting the Massey Pacifica Club Association as an executive, as well as a contributor to their cultural events and festivals, and soon will become a Fiji Flying Sevens player. Kere kere, a round of applause for Tupou Veiogo.
Nisa mbuli vanaka, akinde wa kemnia na yalan toka, kena mor marau, mbongi vanaka nikua. And warm Pacifica greetings to all families, friends, sponsors, judges, Minister of Pacific People Team, the wonderful Mr. Minister Apito, and the amazing Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern. As I stand here tonight in the house of the Lord, to give all the praise and glory to our Heavenly Father for bringing us here all safely and blessed in being part of tonight's special occasion in celebrating Pacifica's success. As recipients, we all have our stories. My educational journey started here in Palmerston North, New Zealand, since 2015. I'd like to thank Palmerston North Boys High School and Massey University for the excellent educational service and developing students of outstanding character. I believe this award was achieved through my positive work ethic and attitude, because for me, attitude is everything. You know, from all the late nights trying to finish the assignments, attending Monday 8 a.m. lectures, and having oxygen H2O for breakfast was the experiences that I'll never forget as a student. I would like to make special thanks to my beautiful parents, Apaitia and Titile Veong, for coming all the way from Fiji to be here tonight. You are my role models. You know, it wasn't really all your disciplines, teachings, hidings, and all the chores. But it was your hard work, success, and leading by a good example that still inspires me and my siblings. Thanks to my older sister, Milniai, who's in Fiji and can't be here at the moment, for setting a good example and always supporting me through my journey. Also to my twin brother, Etuate, for being here and always pushing me to my limits. I want to thank Dr. Nick Ross-Scrooge for being here and also supporting us Pacifica students in Messi. You know, from teaching and to feeding us, he was an absolute blessing to our Pacifica community in Messi. Also acknowledge my grandparents, uncles, aunties, and cousins back in Fiji for all their prayers and support. You know, if only Adrian would have bought tickets to bring the whole family village over, it would be extra icing to the cake. Also, last and most importantly, I'd like to make special thanks to Lisa, Makareta, Lorinda, and Linda and Deloitte New Zealand for sponsoring, establishing, and making this internship possible. I'm excited and blessed to receive this award and looking forward to the experiences and opportunities ahead. Thank you all for making it tonight and have a blessed evening. Nakwalivu.
Thank you so much. Every time I meet Fijians, I have to put on the accent as well. Eh? Set. And always ends up Russian. I don't know. It's so weird. Eh? Kira kira. Tosomai. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now the next award is the Community Star Award. The sponsor is Auckland Council. What a wonderful place, Auckland. I'll just keep that quiet. The presenter for this award is Phil Wilson, the Director of Governance at Auckland Council, and Merla Edmondson, the GM of Libraries. Haere mai, nō mai. All right, the winner is Janelle Augsburg. A round of applause. Janelle is 23 years old, of Tongan and New Zealand European descent. She is currently in her final semester at the University of Auckland studying a Law and Arts Conjoint, or BALLB if you want to be awesome and cool, double majoring in Pacific Studies, Politics and International Relations. From the Mates Mentoring Scheme to Unibound, Janelle has been a strong mentor to young Pasifika people and was selected as an ongoing mentor for the Pasifika students studying towards a tertiary foundation certificate. A round of applause for Janelle Augsburg. Well done.
Sorry. Whakatapu ki a otoa, au me a fio. Whakatapuki e eiki, palemia, ha minista o tawi lakanga o e tāpuleanga ko Nusila. Koleke o hufanga he ngahi whakatapu, kai atā ke o whakahoko hoku whatongia. O kua ulau ka o aki, ai hala tuku tonga, taulanga whāua, maufanga. Today's a full circle moment for me. Earlier this year, I was standing in this very room as part of the free parliament tour. And so it's crazy to think that I'm standing amongst Pasifika trailblazers and on the same stage as Jacinda Ardern. I'm humbled, I'm honoured, and I'm truly empowered to continue the work I've been doing in my community. What I have done is not new, it's not groundbreaking, nor am I the first person to do it, but I am truly passionate. I come from a family of strong Tongan women. They give their whole heart to our family and to our communities. So to give to the community is embedded in my culture, and it's embedded in my way of life. I dedicate this award to my mother, Halabau Kofegi Maunga Augsburg. She taught me what it truly means to give without hesitation, love with my whole heart, and work extremely hard. Maloa pito tu alfatu.
Congratulations, Janelle. Man, I'm getting emotional. Is anyone else getting emotional? I keep saying it's hay fever. Or gout, I don't know. Gout in my eyes. All right, now the next recipient, still with the Community Star Award, sponsored by Auckland Council, is Dejale Sili Palota Kopa. Yeah. Pats mai. Now, Dejale is 23 years old, of Samoan descent, and is currently studying law and Pacific Studies at the University of Auckland. She has been active, a volunteer mentor and leader for a wide range of charities and organisations, from being the president of ASTRA, Auckland Community Services Club, coordinator of Health Packs for Starship, being an ambassador for the Heart Foundation, being a marshal for the annual Pride Festival, and being a blood donor to a shaking bucket for the Breast Cancer Foundation. All this was done out of her passion to love and serve others. Ladies and gentlemen, Dejale Sili Palota Kopa. Pats mai.
Yeah, e momo lava ona whaafoe levi inga ma le whaafitai le atua o na olona alofa malona angalei ua mawhai ai ona tato batasi le ne aso matango pie. Talo falava and warm Pacific greetings. I told myself I wouldn't cry and look what happens. I am so honoured and blessed beyond measure to be here today to receive this award to the Ministry for Pacific Peoples and the sponsor of this award, Auckland Council. I am so humbled and I thank you for this opportunity. It's not to recognise and acknowledge me, but rather the amazing and diverse communities I've been so blessed to work alongside over the years. Excuse me. You know, and my only hope in life is to always spread love and light, joy with others. And I owe everything to my parents. Only my mom is here today, but my dad and my brothers are supporting me from home. They're migrants from Samoa, and they managed to gift me with such a beautiful life. And for that, I'm indebted to them. And I thank you all so much for this opportunity. All I have to say is cheers to always spreading love, cheers to breaking boundaries, and also cheers to the amazing award recipients tonight. Cheers to always keeping the faith and to always believing that our micro efforts have a macro effect. And I'm so honoured. Whaafetai lava mai ia manuia.
Congratulations, Dejale. Ladies and gentlemen, the next award that I have here is the International Scholar Award. The sponsor is Air New Zealand, supported by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade. Can I please invite forward Cath O'Brien from Air New Zealand, Manager of Regulatory Affairs and Government and Industry Affairs. And representing MFAT, or Ministry for Foreign Affairs and Trade, is Charlotte, and who is a manager from Air New Zealand, to come forward, please. And the winner of this award is Okirano. Oh! Haere mai. My apologies. I ran out of data, so I didn't quite hear what you said. Sorry. I'm using Digicel Tonga, of course. Wow. Sad. That's really mean. My apologies, ladies and gentlemen. A bit of a mix-up there. So we're going for the Leadership Award. Oh, thank goodness got that one right. Leadership and Inspiration Award. And the winner is Okirano Tilaia. Congratulations.
Now, Okirano is 17 years old, of Samoan descent, and is head boy at Kashmir High School in Christchurch. His leadership skills were evident in his involvement in the community responses to the mosque's shootings in Christchurch on the 15th of March. He was also invited to do a tour of schools in Samoa to experience and hear the stories of young people in the Pacific nations. Following this tour, he collaborated with journalism students from the National University of Samoa to create a documentary showing the experiences of young people he had encountered from his trip. Oh, all right then. Am I in it? Vinaka. I think I'm in it. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Selfie Okirano.
First and foremost, I want to thank my Heavenly Father, the man above. For if it wasn't for his grace, I wouldn't be standing here today in front of you. As Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. And I believe that every single day of my life. I want to thank the Prime Minister, the ministers, all the people behind the scenes that has made this evening an amazing evening. I want to thank my pilot council, a group that has embraced me and has given me so many opportunities to thrive and understand who I am as a young Pasifika person in New Zealand. I want to thank my family who are here today, my grandma, my grandma, who's a prayer warrior, always praying for me, and is the backbone of who I am. I want to thank my brothers who are here today. My parents couldn't make it tonight, but they've always been with me through thick and thin. They've provided food on the table, a roof over our heads, and just clothes on our backs. And I want to thank them for everything they've done. You know, they worked two to three jobs just to give me and my brothers a better life. This leadership and inspirational award is not only a win for me, but a win for every young Pasifika person who has stood up for what they believe in, even against the world. A win for every young Pasifika person who has stood up in the face of adversity. And something that I want to impart to everyone today is a message from a young Pasifika man that I once saw on Campbell Live. And in his speech he said, "Do not be afraid to be the first to graduate, the first to climb, the first prime minister or the first good wife. Do not be afraid to be the change, not a change in skin tone or colour, but a change in mindset." And lastly, I want to thank my spiritual father, Apostle of Fire, Mama Kara, for their prayers and everything. Shalom, shalom, shalom. God bless.
Malo Opito Okirano. I must say, I saw him on TV, but I didn't realize he's really that tall. I might ask for your suit later on. It might fit my pinky. My sincere apologies, ladies and gentlemen. Now, the next award is the International Scholar Award. And the sponsor is the Pacific Corporation Foundation. And can I please invite Andrew Wilson to come forward, please? Ah, we've got it right this time. Praise the Lord. I'm not going to die. There he is. All right, and the recipient is Sela Tupo Batsepa Maka. Popaspaspa. Now, Sela is 20 years old and was born in the Kingdom of Tonga, the first recipient of King Tupouwono's Coronation Scholarship, and received recognition from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade as one of the top academic achievers in 2018. In her first year at Massey University, Sela was part of a team who won the Creative Solutions Award for the Wine New Zealand industry in her engineering project course. She was also selected as a summer intern in a global engineering consultancy, GHD, in Palmerston North. Congratulations, Sela Tupo Batsepa Maka.
Well done.
Ki mo ape fai kulea ko uak fa fitai pe ki e ki, he kohi, kohi ape ko o mea iwi pe ma poto. To God be the glory. Honourable Prime Minister, distinguished guests, fellow awardees and audience, greetings to you all. 3 years ago, my mom emailed me an article about this event, and I was incredibly inspired, but I never imagined myself to be standing here today and having the Prime Minister listen to me speak live. So I'd like to acknowledge Ministry for Pacific Peoples for paving a way for our students from the Pacific to gain recognition outside of our homes through the International Scholar category. I know so many of us islanders sacrifice the comfort of their own homes to face challenges different to what we have been raised in, and so I acknowledge them as well. I would like to thank Pacific Cooperation Foundation for sponsoring the award. I'm really happy to be one of your recipients again. Also, special thanks to my mom, a very busy woman, but she came all the way from Tonga just to be here today. I'd like to thank my family in Auckland and in the States who couldn't be here today. Salome Finau, Elisiva Helu, and Saateki Maka for being here in this special event, and of course my family and my friends. Last but not least, I dedicate this award to my late father, whose life filled with sacrifice, selflessness and love has molded me into the person I am today. Tonight I'd like to share a Tongan proverb, as I think it's fitting as the international scholar. This proverb I'm very fond of and is called Alai Sia, Alai Kolonga. Skillful on the mound and skillful in the hut. This derives from the practice of snaring pigeons called Heo Lupe. The mound on which the pigeon was trapped in is called the Sia, while the cooking place is called the Kolonga. This proverb refers to individuals who possess the ability to excel in multiple contexts, a trait highly regarded by early Tongans. The wisdom is that we as people have greater success at surviving if they are adaptable, skillful, and functional in more than one environment. Although it's an old Tongan proverb, it's still very evident today. And this is through my fellow awardees and all of you sitting here today. I'm truly grateful and humbled that I get to celebrate this with you all. Maloa pita en tua awhātu.
Congratulations, Sela. She also reminded me of an old Tongan proverb. I karetahi will win the World Cup.
Sorry.
I made that up. My mom told me that one. Now, the next award, big indulgence, Prime Minister, is the Science, Technology, Engineering and Mathematics, or STEM Award, sponsored by Reddit Institute. The representative is Melanie Ruffle, who is a stakeholder and relationships manager. And the winner is Eteroa Lafaele. Congratulations. Eteroa is 23 years old and of Samoan descent. She completed a bachelor degree in computer and information science, majoring in software development, and completed work as a researcher programmer with the University of Auckland and Victoria University. Oh my goodness me. She has gone on to help develop a website for a school department, founded a STEM academy at Auckland University of Technology, and has mentored many Pacifica students through the Oceania Leadership Network, OMG Tech, oh, I like that, South Auckland STEM and Schools. One of the youngest members of PASI, or Pacifica Advocate for Students in Technology, Eteroa was selected to be a mentor and has contributed towards giving young Pacifica students the tools and guidance needed to further their interest into a potential career pathway in STEM. Ladies and gentlemen, Eteroa Lafaele.
Fatalo fatu, topa ia, matoma malule ne afi afi. And one more love out to see the fifth time, and vinga letua, a while long angle lay, malong fat maongi tato tangata. Talo for lava, my name, thank you, John Bulu, such a fan. My name is Eteroa Tusipepa Umanga Lafaele, Namla Ulu, bless. I come from the village of Fongapoa in Fa'asililianga in Savai, and also in Lumwenga Tuai and Lefanga in Upolu. Ooh, praise. I just want to say thank you so much to the Ministry of Pacifica Peoples and also to Reddit Institute for choosing me and giving me this amazing opportunity. I'm going to, you know, dedicate this award to three particular groups of people, not four, not five, not 15, bless. But the first group of people I'd like to dedicate this award to is my family. Mom, Dad, Te Whai Ili Tuia Ana, Yo Sua La Whaele, and Tim, thank you so much for your endless support. Second, oh, my heart's getting heavy now, bless. Oh, it was even with you too, family. But I'd like to really dedicate this award to, you know, the place of champions. My hometown, Cannons Creek, Porirua. Yes. Yeah, 5024 every day, bless. If a sister from Cannons Creek can come out as a software engineer, then imagine the talent that can come out from that amazing suburb. My heart will always beat for this hometown of mine, even though I'm working in Auckland. But man, bless. Is the mayor here? Sorry. Bless. But also, last and not least, I would love to really dedicate this to the past and to the present and to the future of Pacifica people in STEM. It is rough. It is tough. And there is not enough of our people in these areas. Now, I'm speaking as a software developer, and I think it's the same as everyone else. You are the only one in there, brothers and sisters. But if we have the atmosphere, or if we can plan a cousin's wedding last minute, we can definitely solve problems. Definitely solve problems. Yes. Yes. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you want a field and you want to come into STEM, you already have it hard-coded with you today. Thank you very much. Whaftai, whaftai, te lava, soifua. Yes.
Thank you very much, Eteroa Lafaele. If you want to see her again, you can catch her at Ifakasan, Cannons Creek. She'll be putting away the chairs and table and making cups of tea. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now we have two more awards to go, and it's nearly midnight. Still with the Science, Technology, Engineering and Mathematics, or AKA STEM Award, this time it's sponsored by Fonterra. Fonterra, and the representative is Dr. Balatasa Javier, Principal Research Scientist, Fonterra Research and Development Centre. Lovely to see you, Balatasa. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this award is Ioane Fiso. Ioane is 18 years old, of Samoan and New Zealand European descent, and attends at Scots College in Wellington as a school prefect and leader. He has a keen interest in the STEM subjects and is focused on pursuing a career in aeronautical engineering, oh my goodness me, with the goal of being involved in the space industry. In November 2018, he was invited by Sir Richard Taylor to attend a presentation by world-renowned physicist Michio Kaku. Did I say that right? Oh, Michio. All right. The Future of Humanity as a VIP guest. Now, in December 2018, he participated in a workshop at the Adler Planetarium in Chicago and then visited the National Air and Space Museum of Washington, D.C. Oh, my goodness me. You're amazing, Ioane. Congratulations. A round of applause. Ioane Fiso.
The Pacific ability to navigate and explore fearlessly is well known throughout our history and has been recorded significantly. This award is not only going to allow me to manifest my own ability as a young scientist in the world, but also expand that throughout the Pacific community in New Zealand, Aotearoa, which is a dream that I've had for since as long as I can remember. Now, I'd like to first acknowledge the Honourable Prime Minister, Honourable Jacinda Ardern, for being able to give me this award and award me something, an opportunity that I can take into the world, knowing that I can give back to my community, which has been able to make me the man I am today. I'd also like to thank my family, who have been the most honest support, diligent all the way through to the very beginning, all the way to the end. And I'd like to say that the wisdom that they've been able to provide me with and the courage that they've been able to instill in my heart has been able to lead me to the places that I am today and the opportunity at every corner throughout this life that I've been blessed with. I'd also like to acknowledge Dr. Palatasa and Fonterra for their honest work and for their ability to give me this award, which I am so gratefully able to accept today, and for the opportunity that I'm looking forward to in the future to work forward as a young scientist in the world today, to represent not only New Zealand, but the Pacifica brothers and sisters that I've been able to forge the future with today. I'd like to also acknowledge my friend Roderick Sola, who is here tonight, who has been able to support me, someone who I've been able to look to in our local Pacifica community, and not only that, but see his hard work ethic that I've been able to take away from myself and learn many things from. Overall, I'd like to also thank the Ministry of Pacifica Peoples for being able to open this door to me into this amazing opportunity, in particular, Minister Apito, and for being able to... Boss. Apito. I'd also like to thank my extended family who's not able to be here today, and you know what I mean by extended family, there's in the hundreds of them. So out there, thank you very much for all of the support that they've been able to instill in me as well. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, Ioane, and he's only 18 years old. Man, he's old. All right, now the last award, ladies and gentlemen, is the Language, Culture and Identity Award. Now this special award is sponsored by the Ministry for Pacific Peoples, and the presenter who will be giving away this award is Laulu Mek Leawanai, the CE or Chief Executive. And the winner is Luisa Vailuanga. Congratulations. Luisa Vailuanga is currently in Tuvalu, but receiving the award this evening is Mr. Yosefa Vailuanga and Mrs. Niutupu Vailuanga, her parents. Luisa is 22 years old, of Tokelauan and Tuvaluan descent, proudly representing her cultures, traditions and values, although being born in New Zealand. In 2014, she was deputy head girl of Sacred Heart College in Napier and was awarded ducks and a scholarship to attend university, recently graduating with Bachelor of Commerce, double majoring in commercial law and marketing from the University of Auckland. I believe we have a video clip that we're going to play. So, roll VT. Press play.
The Malawat the Prime Minister of New Zealand, Jacinda Ardern. The Malawat the Minister of the Pacifica, Aupito Sua William Steele. Malawat the Gaukami. The Malawat Tino New Zealand Gatoa. Whanau tu Walutokelau, Ilunga New Zealand nei. E maalunga vikinga mo tā vainga o te tamana I te langi, mo te ola mo te maalosi e tū mauilunga e tātou katoa. Your Excellency Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern, the Honourable Minister of Pacific Peoples Aupito Sua William Steele, to all distinguished guests, different ethnic groups and my Tuvalu and Tokelauan people in New Zealand. First and foremost, I give glory, praise and honour to our Heavenly Father for his love and kindness which endures forever. I'd also like to sincerely apologise for not being able to attend this prestigious ceremony in person. However, I have my parents to thank, Vailuanga and Nutupu Yosefa, for accepting this award on my behalf. Our Nukulaila community in New Zealand was invited to perform at the Pacific Islands Forum hosted here in Tuvalu this year. I've been fortunate enough to be a part of this group. This journey back home has allowed me to strengthen my knowledge about my language, culture and identity. Our shores are affected by climate change immensely. I realise the importance of sustaining our tū mo'anga nō, our traditional way of life, which was a prominent theme during the forum. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank New Zealand leaders and delegates for standing side by side with Tuvalu in its fight for climate justice. This award isn't mine alone, it's my family's, it's my whenua, my country's Tuvalu Tokelau, ia tātou katoa. The responsibility that comes with it is one I'm prepared to take in amplifying our leo in the wider Pasifika discussion. Our Prime Minister Inelea Sabuanga spoke about climate change being the Goliaths of today, that we must be the Davids. Tūlakinga o takitaki tūvalu ke foi tasi tātou. As leaders, we must stand and paddle together as one. Whakwhetailasi.
Sipikana. Would you like to say a speech, Mum and Dad?
I think we might as well just close it down. John Paulo Whawhetai, Whawhetai Lasi. Honourable Prime Minister, Aden. Peter William Shua. I can't say enough, it's already been said. However, as a father, as a mother, there is only one Fatele, sorry, by the way, Fatele, Peter tried to dance, but only to one fraction. Unfortunately, Jacinda Ardern did not dance. My daughter, Luisa, danced to perfection. The Fatele can only be expressed in words like this. Taungangana tau leo, peteli eva foa, ne fatiei tau laupua. For your language, your dialect, your church, your marae is where the offshoot stems from. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all I want to say. She has said all. Thank you very kindly.
Malo Alpito, Prime Minister and Minister Alpito,
you may come back to your seats. Framole more.
Now I'd like to invite the Chief Executive of the Ministry for Pacific Peoples, Laulu Mekleawanai, to address you with the closing remarks. Malo.
O te moai whātālofa atutpa ia malima malu la fia. Ke rana, ke ora, whakalofalai atu, ni sapule vinaka, halo le keta, malo le lei, malo ni, talofa, malo le soifua maua, malelangi mamā.
As the Prime Minister walks out to her duties, we want to acknowledge your presence here, Prime Minister, and thank you for all that you're doing and for supporting the awardees tonight. Whaftai te le lava. And thank you also to the Minister for Pacific Peoples, the Honourable Alpito William Su'a Sio. Minister, together we are laying a path so that in future, more of our Pacific young people will have the opportunity to take similar journeys as the ones, as our winners tonight. I'd also like to acknowledge the judging panel. Thank you to our amazing sponsors, Whaftai te le lava. Thank you, and we look forward to our ongoing partnership and looking forward to, as my minister would say to us in our officials meeting, and we need more. So we look forward to more. And thank you to my amazing team, the Ministry for Pacific Peoples, for working tirelessly to making tonight happen. I want to also acknowledge the awardees, the parents. I sit there really, I don't know about you, but really humbled. I reflect back in the 70s and the 80s, the years that I grew up, the 90s. I don't know about you, but I didn't see this kind of talent. You guys are amazing. And our desire for you is to just continue to go, really go. Don't think anything less, and I can see you don't think anything less. We created a vision with our communities, and this is the vision that we want for you, that we are confident in our endeavors, that we are thriving, that we are resilient, that we are prosperous, Pacific Aotearoa. Soifua mai manuia.
Malo Apito Laulu. I believe that's the bell, Minister Alpito. All right. Oh, fantastic. It's not a fire alarm, everyone. Please don't hesitate to look worried at all. I love how everyone's just sitting here calmly like there's no sound. What was that? Is that a little bird crying? All right, we've come to the end of our program, and we started with a prayer, and now I'd like to invite finish off with the closing prayer, Reverend Hiwena Nuku, to come forward. Malo Alpito.
Let us pray that our Lord, loving God, we thank you for your presence in our midst. We thank you for your gift of our children who received the Prime Minister's Award tonight. How wonderful for us to come and celebrate their success. We thank you for the government, the Prime Minister, Right Honourable Jacinda Ardern. We thank you for the Ministry for Pacific Peoples, Honourable Alpito William Seal. We thank you for the Ministry for Pacific People. We thank you for the sponsors. We thank you for our ancestors and parents, families, and extended family for their sacrifice and the tears of joy. Ke tā bua ki mai mō whakamono ia, ai hoko atu ai whanonga, ai tā bua ki ai awhiona. Pea koe klesa ai ko sisu klais, mō awha atoa, mō whiohi laumari e maoni oni. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for attending this evening's event, and thank you again, Hiweni Nuku. Ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to invite these very special people, the Prime Minister, Honourable Alpito William Seal, our Pacific Caucus winners, key sponsors, judges, and MPP Tautua, to please make your way over to the media wall for an official photo. And then after that, then everyone can have a photo. Please, if you want to do your passport photo, not here, please. I'm begging you, please. So if I could ask and invite those people that I mentioned, so the Prime Minister, Minister Alpito William Seal, the Pacific Caucus, to make their way over to the media wall with our winners, key sponsors and judges, and then after that, everyone can take photos. And enjoy the rest of the evening. Please drink all the free food that's here, because this might be the last time you'll see me. Mā te wā, mālo apito, ofalahiatu. Thank you, John.